Vision and Reflection, by Luz de Maria, the 13th of September 2020. Brothers and sisters, I share with you the details that Saint Michael the Archangel emphasized to me during this vision. After finishing the September 13th message, Saint Michael set the terrestrial globe before my eyes. It looked different from how we can see it now via satellite, its colors being different. Saint Michael says to me, "Daughter, do you see that the earth does not have the greenery to which you are accustomed, and that the seas have taken the place of dry land?" Astonished, I nodded my head affirmatively. Then he told me, "Humanity has not accepted that this disease which is seriously afflicting you is the result of the greed of some scientists and those who rule the world, who have used it to cause evil and take humanity hostage. At this time I have to repeat what our King and Lord Jesus Christ and our Queen and Mother have repeated to you about the misuse of technology. This virus is proof. Evil has very cunningly studied how to bring the people of God closer to technology, as it will be through it that the Antichrist will make himself known to all humanity. This is the reality to which children, adolescents and adults have been very easily led, and without it seeming abnormal to them. Now what our mother told you many years ago is indeed being fulfilled. Homes will be changed into mass concentration camps. And this is what humanity in general is experiencing. This new form of virtual teaching that has arisen has done so with humanity's acceptance and submission. This is resulting in disorder and violence everywhere, and humanity is viewing it as something normal. It is almost being said that violence is something necessary at the moment. This is the danger, that man is facing death at every moment at the hands of his fellow men, without this leading to serious consequences. He showed me how empty human beings look who have little or no faith. I also saw a part of humanity in the fullness of light, and Saint Michael told me, "This is the spiritual plenitude of those who will be part of the holy remnant." I could see long lines queuing for basic necessities, and within divided families this was not easy. On the contrary, I saw how the elderly in particular were being abandoned in the long queues and rejected by their families, as they were regarded as no longer being necessary. What I was really able to observe was the law of the jungle. And the word of sacred scripture is fulfilled, Matthew chapter 24 verses 8-15. Saint Michael showed me hundreds of human beings who are abandoning the faith, because the revelations are not yet being fulfilled. Then he showed me these same people in the tribulation, groaning and pleading for divine help. I saw a great earthquake and I saw the sea flooding the land, and the foolish were not going to high ground but were perishing by drowning. I saw many people drowned because of a volcano emerging from the seabed and creating a tsunami. The heavens turned gray and men were running from one place to another in terror and fright, but people of faith were kneeling and stretching out their arms in worship to God. They were saying, "This is the time we have awaited. Give us faith, God of heaven and earth, give us faith to reach the goal." In those days it will be announced in the news that a supervolcano has erupted and has caused a winter-like climate. Flights and all means of transport between countries are paralyzed. The churches will be full of people asking for confession. And Saint Michael says to me, "Today they ask for mercy, yesterday they were blaspheming against God. Man continues being haughty before God. This generation is living faced with two paths, that of grace and that of slavery to sin. There will be suffering in many countries, their inhabitants will rise up against their rulers, those who dominate humanity, and these are not presidents but leading Freemasons who are preparing the single government, who are fostering chaos in the nations. War will be declared and start. And Saint Michael exclaims, "Humanity, do not be obstinate, convert. You are being held captive in order to separate you from the Most Holy Trinity, and without God, man is surrendering to the devil. Do not carry on living according to the human ego. It is keeping you blind, it stops you from seeing and is making you live in pride, trampling your fellow men." Saint Michael says to me, "Blessed are the poor in spirit, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are those who mourn, for they will be comforted. Blessed are the meek, for they will inherit the earth. Blessed are those who hunger and thirst for righteousness, for they will be filled. Blessed are the merciful, for they will receive mercy. Blessed are the pure in heart, for they will see God. Blessed are the peacemakers, for they will be called children of God. Blessed are those who are persecuted for righteousness' sake, for theirs is the kingdom of heaven. Blessed are you when people revile you and persecute you and utter all kinds of evil against you falsely on my account. Rejoice and be glad, for your reward is great in heaven, for in the same way they persecuted the prophets who were before you." Saint Michael leaves and asks God's people for perseverance.